Okay, congratulations, Janine. First of all, no, we've seen the music video sa labas. Ang lakas maka-LSS. Parang ilang minutes pala ako nandun. Nasa utak ko na siya. Pero, syempre gusto namin munang malaman the story behind your single, alas dos na.
Yeah, so I wrote this song because I was 15. So it was a couple years ago. I just broke up with someone, like my high school boyfriend, my first boyfriend ever. Tapos, the song's really just about that, na parang nagre-regret ako na bakit ko siya iniwalayan, kasi dapat love of my life ko na siya. Alam mo yung feeling na ganun. Pero after a few months, parang, ba't ko nasulat to? Ew. Parang ganun naman. No, pero really, that's what the song's about. So, 2 a.m., kasi that's when I wrote the song, and it's really when 2 a.m. is usually the time na we're overthinking, tapos parang dun pumapasok yung mga dapat ginawa ko to, dapat hindi ko to ginawa, ganon. So, that's really what the song's about, just regrets. So, it's very naive, very teenager, pero it is an honest, parang an honest feeling. So, I'm very proud of the song.
What prompted you to release this now? Kasi if you have written this nung 15 ka pa, diba? Yeah. Tas ngayon siya lumabas.
Yeah. Well, I was really about to release this before, like, a few years ago, that was JK was supposed to produce it. Like, we were working on it in the studio. So this has a touch of JK. And it never really came into fruition, but now that I'm under UMG and we're working on a project, and the project just really aligns, like the song really aligns with the project, and it tells the same emotion and the same feeling. So, and apart from how I really like the song, how I really like how the song is sonically, parang sobrang sakto niya lang talaga sa album. Yun. I said album. Project.
Nung nirecord mo, napa-flashback ba ang mga feelings at emotions when you were 15 and writing this from your heartbreak?
Yeah. Parang ganun kasi talaga sa music eh. Parang it unlocks like a memory every time. Like when you listen to something, it's like, damn, like that's how I used to feel. So that's why I love music, and my goal really in every release is to talk about an emotion that we all went through. So I feel like kahit hindi to yung pinagdaanan mo ngayon, it's still a shared story. Sa, like, parang universal pa rin siya sa lahat. Kasi tayo lahat were like this at some point.
Pero what were your realizations now that you're 22 tas nabasa mo yung
parang yun, so bakit? Yun talaga parang why? And it's kinda honestly feels kinda weird just like admitting that I wrote this about my high school boyfriend that I've forgotten already. Na it feels weird, but also I just like take pride in being honest in my art. So, even though it feels kind of cringy, parang ew, I'm still very excited about it because I know a lot of people have went through the same thing and maybe is still going through the same thing. So that's what's important, because music has to be there for you in all journeys of life. So, yeah, and I'm still very proud of the song.
Kanina yung mention na yung nga, you've planned ni JK na mag-collaborate dito, ganyan, and natuloy na siya, diba? Yeah. So, yung mismo collaboration, how was it? How was it working with your friend? And
the working of this song?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, now I have a band. I work with TJ on guitars, TJ Casillo on guitars, Luke Casanova on bass, and Kirk Basilio on drums. And we've been a band for a year now. And it's been a dream working with them kasi I feel like before when I didn't have a band, I was very limited because we are all limited in a lot of ways. And I just don't have enough knowledge to express what I want to express. But working with them, especially on this song, parang feeling ko sobrang comfortable lang ako and nalabas ko talaga lahat ng gusto kong ilabas. Kahit from the riff itself, ng gitara, yung emotion talaga na mararamdaman mo. Like, yung palo ng drums, parang yun yung frustration, ganun. So, it's amazing always to work with my band and my friends in music.
intense nga eh.
Intense!
Sa ano, kanina nung pinakikingan namin doon sa labas.
Kasi yun talaga nabifeel ko noon, parang sobrang frustrated ko. Shit, hindi pwede na naghiwalay kami. Ba't ko ba siya iniwan? Ganon. Ganon yung feeling.
Nasa na yun yung ano mo ng 15 years old ka?
Hindi ko alam. Dead ba na? Please, wag mo ito panoorin. Pwede bang i-block siya? Nakaya kasi. Pero, thank you siguro. Laman.
At least yung bagong single, di ba? Meron naman siya na idulot. Na maganda. Pero Janine, we've seen na nag-evolve na rin talaga yung style mo. And even kung paano ka, yeah. Paano mo dalhin yung self mo, ganyan, since you won tawag ng tanghalan, di ba, ang tagal na rin nun. So, Paano yung naging, ano, deliberate effort for you to transition, to change? Yeah.
I think, well, really, I just grew up talaga normally, like everyone. So, I was 15 when I joined the contest, and I was really just growing up. So, right now, I'd like to think I'm just like a collage of all the people I look up to, like, my influences really shaped me, so I'd like to say I'm grateful na I look up to people who, I look up to good people na respect their art, respect what they do, respect the people around them. So, yun, parang mas naging comfortable lang talaga ako sa sarili ko because I see people na who I want to be, ganun.
Sa iyo mismo, ano na yung mga ano, parang nabago when you were looking back?
Well,
years before.
Well, ano, siguro yung super, I don't know if this is like a good thing. I mean, maybe it's a good thing. Before, nung hindi pa ako sumasali sa TNT, sobrang delusional ko talaga na parang, sobrang galing ko, ganun, like, well, I'm so different. You know, like, when I have a chance, I will show everyone, I'm so cool, ganun. Tapos, when I, parang nung pumasok ako sa industry, tapos reality settled in, parang mas naging aware ako na parang, ha, parang ganito pa pala ako, parang ang liit ko pa, parang ang dami ko pang need malaman, ang, like ang layo-layo ko pa sa gusto kong mangyari. And I'm not that, I'm not anywhere near all that. So, I feel like, being in the industry really humble, I feel like I was humbled along the way, and that fed my hunger, like, or it didn't really feed my hunger, that made my hunger grow even more siguro na parang ang dami ko pang kailangan gawin. So that helped me become more comfortable then of learning more and experiencing more, and feeling ko na mas na-shape ako na mas naging comfortable ako sa sarili ko, na okay lang kung wala pa ako masyadong alam kasi marami din kaming wala pong masyadong alam and marami pa akong matututunan, ganun. So, yun na ba. I don't know if that made sense, sorry.
Mm-hmm. Oo naman. Pero yung transition din from, of course, eto bagong chapter din sa career mo, na that you're with UMG, Island Records. So, paano yung naging transition din? Kasi, syempre, parang medyo nag-goodbye ka dun sa first home mo, diba?
So, well, my first home, it was very, like, heartwarming naman yung, ano, kasi I really asked them na if I could go on being independent, kasi, I went into this 15 knowing nothing, delusional, parang wala pong alam sa industriya. Tapos, parang nanalo ko sa contest agad. Andun ako parang hindi ko nagigets kung ano talaga yung galaw, kung ano talaga yung music. So, I asked to be independent just to know what really is good for me, just to explore na kung ano talaga yung out there, na kung sino-sino yung mga musicians na pwede ko palang makatrabaho, makausap, ma-immerse into, like that. So, I'm very grateful na they supported me naman. And when I was indie, like, I learned a lot. And then, I'm very grateful na UMG supports and believes in me. And they really want to support my vision. And they share the same dreams as mine and the same beliefs in the industry as mine. So, I'm very grateful kasi now I feel like I'm more equipped with the experience that I went through, and I'm more comfortable, and I'm 22 now, so I feel the most myself ngayon. So compared to before na parang akong natatakot akong gumalaw kasi wala pa akong alam, ganun.
So it's more of you yung ano talaga, yung nag-grow sa sarili, ganun.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So with that, ano ang mga future plans sa bagong chapter ng iyong career?
Well, I feel like, you know, I just have a lot of dreams for OPM. So my big goals are really like I want to put us out there. I want to help people be out there, ganun. Para gusto ko lang talaga mag-elevate yung OPM and maging mas honest yung OPM. So hindi tayo takot gumawa ng kahit ano na parang weirdo naman to, pero hindi yun weird, parang we can do anything with music. So yun talaga yung pangarap ko and what I really want to do with my music, just more authenticity to my music, to OPM in general.
Sino pa gusto mo makakolab? Mga friends mo?
Dami. Well, I really wanna experience working with my idols ever since sila Unique Salonga, sila Zild, Kuya Blaster, Sir Pajau, everyone, the Four of Spades. You know, the former Four of Spades. And them individually, their music individually is insane, and it's just a dream to just, kahit hindi kami magtrabaho, kahit mapanood ko lang sila, paano ba sila gumalap? Kasi ang galing nila, sobrang idol ko sila. Pero syempre yung mga international, I really look up to Miley Cyrus and Billie Eilish, of course. Mga ganun, mga songwriters I wanna work with. And yeah, yun talaga.
So ngayon, Janine, mas focus mo talaga ay music mo.
Yeah, I feel like really I'll always just be music because that's really who I am. When I was in my, you know, basta before, like, I was told to maybe try out acting, but I don't really think I'm for that, because, like, I know in myself, I'm like, no. Pero feeling music talaga yung akin eh. And siguro, ano, I like to pride myself kasi in giving my best in the sonic experience, yung music, but also the visual experience. So yung mga music video, I'm really into film and like that, but more on like the concept wise. So I don't really want to be in front of the camera, but I want to keep pushing out visual arts and like sonic art. Ganun.
So yung music video, ikaw ang nag-isip noon, nung concept?
Yeah, and even when I was indie, I worked with the same prod house, the same director, Direct Jonets of Toothless Studios. So when I was indie, I took a, well, hindi mo siya risk kasi wala namang mawala sa akin, pero inas ko siya kung open mo sila mag-work with me like that, and I'm really glad because I look up to them a lot and they're very good filmmakers, and we worked with them now in Alas Dos, and I presented to them my concept, ganon, tapos Direct Jonets is insane, yung utak niya grabe, so Jonets and Miko Del Rosario, and grabe, na pull off talaga na sobrang galing. Dapat mapanood nila. Dapat mapanood nyo.
Ayun. Thank you so much, Janine.